homily of the 24th Sunday in Ordinary Time, Year B. The cost of following Jesus. Most of us follow Jesus without even knowing who he is. Jesus therefore reveals himself to us. There is a movement from a more general question, who do people say I am, to something more particular, but you. He asks, who do you say I am? To this question, the disciples, through the intervention of Peter, recognized Jesus as the Christ. Unfortunately, they had a dream of a Messiah who would restore the kingdom of David by military might, casting out the Romans, casting out the oppressors. Jesus, however, brings them to understand that the Messiah is a suffering Son of Man who will be rejected, killed, and then will rise. Following of Jesus Christ is serious business. We may have proclaimed a message of faith like Peter, who recognized that Jesus is the Christ. When Jesus says he is going to suffer and be killed and then rise from the dead, Peter says, no way. Following Christ then is not just a matter of knowing the beliefs of the faith. Christ is calling us to something more than this. He is calling us to be completely sold on his kingdom. He is calling us to put him before everything else in the world. This means being mocked because we take our faith seriously. Following Jesus Christ is a very serious issue. We may have proclaimed a message of faith like Peter, who recognized that Jesus is the Christ. When Jesus says he is going to suffer and be killed and then rise from the dead, the same Peter who professed that says, no way. This means that following Christ then is not just a matter of knowing the beliefs of the faith, reciting the credo, I believe. Christ is calling us to something more than this. He is calling us to be completely sold onto his kingdom. He is calling us to put him before everything else in the world. That means being mocked at because we take our faith seriously. That means being hurt because we refuse to join a crowd that is more pagan than Christian. That means being spat on and hit in the face and even dying for the sake of Jesus Christ. There are people in our neighborhood, at our workplaces, in our schools, who mock at us for our beliefs. There are people who boast that they are good, but who are furious with you when you say that you are not going to get drunk, you are not going to take drugs, or do that which belongs only within the commitment of marriage. Following Jesus is always going to have a cost attached to it. This is because good is always going to be opposed to evil. To make matters worse, evil may appear to be in the norm, the manner of living of a majority. It is just the minority who do that which is wrong, but who try to convince others that their actions are what everybody is doing. Still, the vocal minority can weigh on us. That, coupled with our constant need to control ourselves, can lead us away from the truth in the black hole of sin. It takes courage to be a Christian, to be a real Christian. It takes courage to be a Catholic Christian, a true Catholic, one who is not going to compromise on the truth, that is Jesus Christ. It takes courage to sell out for the Lord. It takes courage to live the Lord's words in today's gospel. Whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself, take up his cross and follow me. If you are not ready to embrace suffering, which Christ are we then following? But he did promise us this. If we follow him, he would be with us, supporting us, caring for us, and winning the final battle over evil for us. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.